Good morning, everyone. Today is Sunday, August 23rd. Yeah, it's Yada's birthday.
Happy birthday, Yada.
Happy birthday, Yada. So, this is the start of today's vlog. Me and Nallah have a lot of things planned for today, but step one is to scavenge. Is that the right scavenge?
It is, baby.
To scavenge. So right here in Greensboro, we're on Gate City. There's a whole pile of bricks, and bricks can be used to accessorize. It can be used to make a spiral.
Yes.
It can be used to use a lot of things. So she's over there taking the stuff to the car because we're gonna use our resources. And I also picked up some wood. I'm gonna use this pallet as well for the raised bed at my crib. So we're just out here repurposing, reusing, recycling all the things. So here's to today's vlog. I hope y'all are ready. We have called ourselves independent contractors. Yeah.
That's what y'all say. I wanna wear this shirt.
You wanna put it on?
I'm gonna put it on.
Okay. Climate Justice League. Climate Justice League, because that's what we do every day. So, just to give y'all a look, we have cherry tomatoes, we have peppers, we have more tomatoes, cucumbers. Oh, let me show y'all, because cucumbers, more cucumbers and peppers. We got corn. Look at corn. Corn is such a blessing. And some more peppers. And that's a watermelon. That's not ours. Just some more tomatoes and cucumbers. So we're going to be trying to, we have all of them laid out here. We're going to be putting them in smaller bags and then putting them in bigger bags. So she's back. So we're matching. Just so that we can get them out to some folks that need it. And because who doesn't want vegetables? It's corn. Like, come on now.
And we will be wearing gloves.
Yes. COVID is real. So washed hands and everything. You already know the vibes. So I'm going to set up the time lapse for you guys. And you guys will see everything that we're doing. Much love. Hi, you guys. So we're out here harvesting some basil. I love saying gardening words. It feels so like harvesting. So we put some basil and some zip ties. And so I'm just going to go ahead. Maybe I'll try to put it down more so you guys can see what I'm doing. Oh, I can't really see. But it's okay because I'll show you guys. So basically when you're harvesting plants, you want to cut. Let me just show you an example. You want to cut directly at not the root, but the stem of the plant so that it has the ability to grow back. And also my friends just taught me that you want to harvest from the bottom of the plant. So if you look at the bottom of this plant, there's a plentiful amount of basil versus the top. So if you harvest from the top, then you know what I'm saying? It may not grow back as fast versus the bottom. Okay. So, harvesting. And so, yeah, we just are just packaging a few of these. This will be like a special gift inside of the food bags we're giving out today. We're giving food to elders today. Some other folks hit us up saying they wanted some food. So I'm really excited about it. And basil is amazing for your spaghetti. I swear, it'll give it a whole different vibe, a whole different taste. So I was just using a little knife to cut directly at the root. And there we go. And I'm just gonna put it in the bag. And then I'll just keep going all the way. So harvesting is really, it's an easy way to share your food, to share your food with the people around you, because there's no reason why. What are we gonna do with this whole basil plant ourselves? So it's good that we're sharing and giving back. So, yeah. my princess is here.
Hola.
Hola.
She's over here putting in the work.
You know what I'm saying? Hola. Aren't we all? So, I'm just happy to be surrounded by humans that love doing the same thing I do. Okay. You know what I'm saying? It's for the people.
That's
so
good.
So,
mm-hmm. And then, what? You put, like, one more big top in there.
Okay.
Yeah.
Like from down here.
Yeah, that's a good
big
one.
Top. She just taught me. These ones?
You know, I don't know if that's the official.
Or she, tops.
Yeah. Okay. Hold on. I'm going to clip it off with.
Oh,
the, yeah.
Nada took a little bit of the stem.
No, you
okay.
Can.
It's okay. She'll grow back. Clip it off.
Yeah.
So that's a big top.
Well, so.
Or like
the
these.
The whole top. Yeah.
Is
yeah.
It, okay.
Yeah. The whole top.
Nallah has book club with some elders, so she took them over there. I have some stored away for my people. Zenithia gave me a snake plant. I'm so excited to put that in my house. And then we're over here with the beautiful, wonderful ladies. We got the beautiful, wonderful ladies, okay? You guys say, hey.
Hey.
And then we can tell them what we're about to do over here. Okay, so.
How you doing?
Hi, how are you? So take it away, Nallah Muhammad.
Yes, hola everyone. We have peppers.
You're gonna have to speak up.
Okay, yeah. You should put some bass in my voice.
Mm-hmm.
We have some peppers already planted, and this is actually a result of the Kids Cafe that is located here in Greensboro, North Carolina.
Shout out.
Yes, shout out to Earth Feather. It is her founding organization in which she teaches the children to grow their own food, as well as how to properly cook it, because a lot of people say they don't like certain vegetarian meals and stuff, but that's because y'all know how to cook it, baby.
Y'all don't know how to cook it.
You don't know how to cook it. Yes, so there's peppers already in there, but what we're going to do is we're going to just add a couple of kale that were started from seed. We're going to put them just a little bit around it simply because there's space. However, the companion plants that would go with peppers are Earth Feather just mentioned, are corn, squash, as well as beans.
Yes.
Yeah. So you normally put those in there so they can just help one another exist.
Exactly.
We're gonna put some kale in there, and
it's
then we're
gonna
weed
vibe.
That bed eventually.
We're gonna get to it. I remember when me and Ivory came and we did this whole thing.
And the one and only Shawnee.
Say hi.
Hi.
To our soon to be master, yeah?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah. These babies for the tower garden that we're also going to set up and put in today.
Yeah. We'll go into depth about that. Y'all don't even know about that. So, yeah, this is where we at today. And Earth Feather is here. Just walking to the building. Sexy Sunday. And that's what we gonna claim. Okay, so we'll talk to you guys later. Bye. Okay, so we're out here with the tower garden. Nallah, You want to talk? Yes, I shouldn't know anything about this.
Tower garden, what it is a hydroponic system, meaning there is no soil involved in getting these babies to grow. And in fact, it may actually increase the rate of production with those. So we use rock wool and a little bit of, don't give me the lion, so I'm not. It's a nutrient that helps the
some mineral blends.
What is it called? Earth, you know, the is it permalite or
vermiculite?
Vermiculite.
Okay, okay.
Vermiculite.
So you're gonna need this on a steady.
Yeah, that's what I was
Bless you. Bless you.
And we have some
sweet
basil.
Okay, let's just wait then. If we can't reach those, you can have
Ish
do it.
Oh, no.
This is a good flatter spot.
There's
nothing
in there. Okay. No, we'll keep that one out.
Okay, we can leave those since there's nothing in them. We're just going to leave those right there. Good job, boys.
I thought there's more right there.
Yeah, there's more space, but we don't have any more with plants in it.
Yeah.
So we're actually going to take this one out, too.
They're all filled up.
Yeah. Okay. We can leave it.
Yeah.
Perfect.
Now we pick this in.
Almost. So
almost
you guys
there.
Have to you guys have to pick who's gonna do what, okay? So who's gonna put the solution in and who's gonna put the water in?
Me.
I'm
about to put the solution in.
Solution in?
Yeah. I'm gonna put the water in.
You perfect. Put the water, so it's